Yeah, let's not get into Swedish pronunciations at the start of the match. Jumping into the pistol here between SK Gaming and Reason. And we are seeing, of course, SK on the defensive side, the CT side at the start. And Cadian taking a nasty bullet to the face right there at the start of the round. And looks like they're actually pushing towards Banana. And I feel like SK got a good chunk of information right at the beginning there. And they are just setting it up for this push on B here. But they're taking things slowly.
EXR is actually lining up a smoke on street, so I'm curious on how they're actually doing this. He's gonna fake a short push? I'm not sure.
SK, they do have three men guarding B. They really feel confident that it's gonna be a B. And they wouldn't be wrong to believe that, because here they come. We see XM on the flank there, but Nilla straight on through with the first frag onto Emilio, also taking down XM as well. So they have the bomb site, but there is pressure coming in from construction. And Rock is making his way in, but look at this. Pitta and Huitten moving in hand
this
in hand
as well.
This is
dangerous for a reason. They got two members really, really low as the push is coming in.
Next to the new boxes there, trying to hold it down. It's just Huitten left at the moment. That P2000, this is going to be really tough there on all angles right now. He's going to have to spin around behind himself and then to the left as well. So many people all over the site, and PNX going to shut him down. Huitten cannot do the job. It's going to be SK losing that first round. So this is sad. Sad times for SK Gaming. But Reason, going to go to that anti-eco, liking the P90 coming out from Nilla. Do you like the P90? Are you a P90 user?
I used to be, but since Titan wanted to bring out the armor pistol second round, it kind of screwed me over. So I stopped using it. I'm using Galil instead, because of the armor penetration, obviously. So yeah, people still like it, but it's not as common as it was before.
Yeah, I'm really liking the Galil lately as well. Galil is awesome. And we're actually seeing here, again, some more Banana action coming in from a Reason.
SK seemed they wanna stack. They wanna stack A.
XM, love it. With the mag, he's gonna take down one. Cannot get anything else. Sad times for XM, but one is at least something. But they're gonna have to really push in hard here and make something. I mean, last time you said they really need at least two frags from this investment, because obviously they did pistol arm. XM had a mag.
Yeah, but now it's kind of like, I mean, he's still got the money bonus, the 900, is it 900?
I think so, yeah, I think that's
so,
that's
I mean, that obviously is a lot better. I mean, he basically refunded his mag, so, yeah, I don't think they actually need that much more.
They want to pick up those exit kills.
Yeah, they just want to force them to stay banana, and they're rotating towards mid now. And kind of want to cram them in. Maybe make a push after the bomb blown.
This is actually really cool. If they pick up some kills here, that would be amazing. Removing some weapons. And it looks like they're just going to keep their pistol armor alive for the next round. And how do you feel in this situation for SK Gaming? Was that an awkward result? Or are you feeling okay after that?
It's okay. I mean, they didn't lose their gunstick and still reuse them this round. And they still got the money, and I mean, it was okay. I mean, I would almost say they actually won that trade, because a mag 7 with the bonus money, and the other team lost the full armored weapon. So yeah, I think SK Gaming did a really good job that.
You can see a bit of boost action from Emilio there, that CZ. Or can he make it work though? That's the question. This is going to be really fun if he can actually get some kills with this. Here they come, edging out onto the position. There's, oh no, he can't get a single one. That's pretty sad, but XM gets taken down too, so it looks like this is going to be the bomb down on B. No problems at all there for Reason Gaming, as you'd expect. And
could be able to take a couple of kills, because Reason seemed really low on health right now. EXR holding that smoking banana. Are they doing some kind of push? Yeah. Pushing the banana through the smoke. Himself takes down PETA in ruins, and they're going for a clean anti-eco. Really good job by Reason.
And there's Rock all alone with the CZ. He doesn't have a skin on it. Maybe he's doing the same thing as you. Maybe he's lost too many matches.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe. Doesn't deserve the skins. I like that you're punishing yourself.
Yeah, I have to. I mean, how else am I going to learn?
All right, so we're going to go into... I should think, looking at the money, they could... Yeah, they can go for a buy here now. Looks like they are going to go for that, get some Famuses in the mix. Not the best buy in the world. They're all right on grenades, I guess.
I would have liked to see less head armors, but it seems like Reasons have a lot of Galil, so I guess it's a fine choice having that many head armors. But an extra aid on Inferno is really, really important, so especially the smokes.
I really like from XM here, he's always going to have to spray down. He does get two frags there with Emilio. And I do really like this play. They try to take control of Banana. They try to throw the deep smoke to get themselves up to logs. But little did they know that Reason was all over Banana. Very unfortunate for them. But they did actually put it to a 3-2 in their favor. So it's just on Peter, Huitin, and Rock to clean up. And that's going to amount to a really nice play from the B guys for SK Gaming. Cadian over by Paul here.
Yeah, the banana guy for CT is really important. If he can stay alive and push in after they make the initial push on site, that's huge. Yeah. There
well
we go.
Well played.
Really good retake and perfect timing by PETA going in like just after the push from Coils, making it a lot easier for the CTs to retake that.
Yeah, I really like that round, and I would love to see more aggression on Banana from the XM Emilio combo, and
it seems like they are doing it because I see Emilio bought a Molotov, and it's pretty popular nowadays to mow down Banana and hold it.
I've loved the kind of counterplay that I've seen a couple of times now, where they boost up in a little plant pot at top of the at the top of slope.
Oh yeah,
that's really cool. That blew my mind when I first saw that. But XM again, you know, getting aggressive Emilio, they do get smoked off here. But I love this aggression. I love how they're trying to take ownership of Banana, and Reason can't really get the map control. And they're not really controlling apartments just yet. They are moving in apartments, but still, it feels like a really awkward battle at the moment for Reason to just get themselves on the map.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah, they're holding everything perfect. Reason cannot really find a hole. They're getting doubled everywhere they go, everywhere they seek a duel, everywhere they try to take a peek. There are two men there, and SK Gaming is playing solid.
It's like they're going to be moving into Banana. This is their kind of last attempt here. This is the only plan they can fall back on. They're only three, so they've got to go for this together. Here they go. It's Emilio and XM in here. And as XM not spotted until it's too late. Takes down two players. Definitely worth it. And there's Exa going to get the bomb planted at the last millisecond. And that's going to be a little bit of bonus money there for a reason. But an otherwise expertly played round from SK Gaming. They are showing a really good CT side. Love it.
Yeah. I mean, they're taking the risks in the beginning of holding Banana. Getting the entry, backing off into really, really defensive setups. Helping each other out. Two men at a time and leaving one guy alone at apartments on A. But really good from SK. Seems like they're really punishing their opponents for going for them for those one-on-one peaks.
So now we have a lot of A's for Reason. A decent, definitely a great buy for them. Again, look at this. They are getting aggressive every round. Oh, he's getting Molotov over at Carl, losing so much health down to 23 as Emilio. They have to play Banana defensively now. Peter locking down the apartments. No entry sign is put up there by Peter as Nilla feels the pain. And now it's a really tough position for Reason Gaming because they kind of gained some ground on Banana, but apartments is kind of anyone's game right now.
Yeah, and they just keep on doing what they keep on doing. They're getting the entries, and that's really, really important for the CTs because it seems like Reason is kind of undecided once a man goes down. And
No plan B.
Yeah, and they're just holding and getting caught off guard.
I'm going to predict that Reason are going to just rush Banana next round because every single round SK Gaming have been pushing to car. Like Emilio was just flashed and Molotov almost to death there. XM going to get a pick onto PNX as he moves through the angle, and Reason just can't quite seem to to get it right at the moment on this.
Wow, this over-rotation is huge by SK. They actually have four guys towards B. And they have a good position on SK.
So we have Cadian now. He's going to go straight for the plant. Oh, perhaps not. He's going to go for the fake. Oh, he doesn't get the kill. Only Quitten going down. And that's not really a big loss. They're really racking up the cash. They've won so many rounds in a row. They've had such minimal losses. Stuff's getting really awkward. And all right, our reason is going to make me look really smart. They're going to rush banana now. That's what I'm looking for.
Seems like, oh, maybe.
No, no.
It's up mid.
No, going to second mid. Damn it. Oh, well. So they're choosing to go apartments. They haven't done a lot in apartments so far. I think this is
the right choice.
Wow, some good work there from Exxon, but MSL's going to pick up that AWP. He's going to be a big player now. There's just three of them left. He's got to use this well. Good frag coming in from Exa to get the bomb down. Nilla, great reactions there on the quad push. Peter all the way in onto the top of the site. Exa does deal with it, but it's now a one-on-one. Emilio is in a good position here as far as health and armor is concerned. He knows where he's spraying away. Good damage going in on top of Exa. What can he do to survive this onslaught? Looks like nothing. He will get dropped in. There's the defuse. Emilio with a great cleanup there to save the day for SK.
But remember, this was an eco round from Reason Gaming. So, I mean, that's an amazing round from them. They have 8k in the bank on almost every player. So they could probably go for two weapon rounds in a row. Yeah, SK, they're getting down on cash now. So if Reason can get two rounds in a row, it's worth three.
And we're seeing Cadian with the AWP again. And we have XM, he's AWPing over. He's going to go for that apartments push. And that is very, very bold. Not all the way, though. And look at this. They are really setting up on mid here. They've kind of given up on banana completely. They haven't really got... They're not really inside apartments. I feel like if SK were a bit aggressive here, they could really dismantle this pressure coming in from Reason. Let's see what they're able to make happen. They're going to pull the switch right there. They're going to go for it. Rocks there, caught in the corner. Does only get one kill. Nilla all the way up into the site. This is looking amazing for Reason. They're going to get the bomb down. And XM, Emilio, and Peter, last guys to deal with this. And it is looking like a really good round so far. Reason have some time to get that post-plant set up in action. And oh, Peter, very key kill over at Graveyard. XM trying to edge his way in on top of the site. There spots another player, perhaps. There it is. Can't quite take him down. Emilio, though. And the 1-on-2, and the time is running out very rapidly here.
Doesn't know where the second guy is. He's holding.
Gonna go for the hold. No!
And
there we go. So good round from Reason. Still very close. But wow, they made that look convincing. That entry was crazy. Nilla was just up in that site straight away.
They learned from that eco that they were really weak, SK, holding short and apartments on flashes, and they kind of used that knowledge from they got from the eco and kind of made a similar push, more pressure on short, of course. They almost got into like the site before they actually realized they were there, because they had so much pressure. Yeah. Like the CTs were holding long, and yeah, they kind of got the site for free. It was a really good push from Reason.
Oh, XM caught off guard by PNX there. Oh, Emilio with the refrag. Very, very brave, but very important to go for that. Very nice. And that's going to even stuff up. So that was a really, really nice play from Emilio. He took a lot of his health away, but still, it's worth it, I think. And and I like how Reason are bringing this back now. It started to look like SK were all over them, but they are looking good now. And they've really taken control of banana. They've pushed SK Gaming all the way back, dealing with that aggression, taking control of apartments. This is looking great for Reason. Another pick onto Pitta as they move through apartments. Quitten now feeling very pressured. He's got no backup from any position, like
both
like Pitta or Library.
Sight on B, so this is really dangerous for Quitten. As Cadian takes him down, he's going to go for an afterplan situation. MSL already taking the rotation off, and they know Emilius came from banana, so they're probably going to try and sneak a peek in middle and see if they can get him, because they know he's low since the entry on banana as well.
I love this. This was such a great round from Reason.
But really it could be round. Worth actually not hunting this round, because I think SK is going to be low on money either way. And yeah, I think they're not taking the risk, it seems. They're just clearing out, looking no one is on the bomb, and saving the free guns. And I think that's an okay decision, because I don't think SK have that much money.
Yeah, we can see now the money is definitely looking pretty bad for SK. Amelia with that AK. I'd love to see, because of the AK, they're going to go and just force the buy. So that's going to be really interesting. What are they going to do with this? Because they could get
really risky. I'm not sure I like it, but yeah. I do think playing CT on Inferno with no nades is probably the most
scary thing.
Yeah, the most scary thing. Because, yeah. Yep. Not being able to actually smoke off B or mid or anything. You kind of have no control over what's happening.
Except there with the stat track Nova. Oh, yeah. So, interesting here. They didn't decide to do anything funky with their buy. Like, I was maybe thinking maybe they're going to go three or four banana, go aggressive or something. But we're seeing them just play it kind of standard at the moment. And it looks like Reason, after taking control of banana, have kind of doubled back, pushed all the way back to apartments and mid. So this is going to be a very strong push onto A. And it's all going to come down to getting that entry frag on the guy on quad. Let's see if they're able to do it. Here goes MSL. There's one frag there onto Rock. Guy at quad does escape, but they did get the first kill for free there almost. And MSL going to smoke off CT Arch. It's going to make SK's life really, really hard. No help, Pitter. You've got to do it by yourself.
Actually, a fake towards B.
I can't believe they did that. They're crazy. They're going to go for this. And there goes the Nova of XM. Does disappear there back to construction. They're going to take over the site here. But do they have time to plant this? I mean, they will, but it's going to be under a lot of pressure here. In they come. XM going to drop Cadian with that Nova. Still alive there with that Nova. Look at him. He's crawling around here. Going to dive through the smoke onto coils. And surely he won't get a frag hit. Oh, almost. Look at that angle. What an angle. And two players left here now for SK as they make their way in. Not going to happen. Emilio does get a kill, but Reason, do you feel like they're overcomplicating things there? Or how do you feel about that double?
I think it was a good call. They were might be a little bit slow clearing the site because they were really worried about all the angles, even though there was no one there. But sometimes the threat is bigger than the execution. But I think it was a really good fake, actually. They got the entry. They were so defensive on A. They had to mass rotate. And it got into an afterplant situation. They handled fine. But props to Miller that round for actually... He had 6 seconds running towards the bomb and actually planting it. And he actually saved them the round there.
Yeah, it definitely was really well played. SK actually held on pretty well, I thought, all things like considering their weapons. Like XM was so sneaky with that Nova, but still, looks like they're going to be able to take this one fairly easily. They did lose one man on the entry towards B. In fact, I think there's still someone in the site. I think, is that Emilio? Still in the site there. He's going to be sneaky from the back with the CZ. They know where he is. Didn't get the kill. He's so low, there are no bullets. Oh, so sad. So depressing. Let's see what else they can do. There's a few of them left. Pitta makes his way up with the P2000. Pitta, he's got some armor on him. Let's see if he can do something with this. CZ too strong there. A couple of them are very weak, so the only problem is that they're all on very different angles. That's really going to be the killer here for Pitta as he makes his way in. There's a very good flash. I don't think they know where he is, though. And oh, he does get the kill into Cadian.
I think he just got team flash there.
Another kill surely to come from the CZ, trying to tap away, and there it is. Does he still have bullets? He still has 12 bullets left. He can go for the direct challenge. He can make this happen. He picks up the AK, and he's going to fall back. Really no good, kit.
Really good round from Peter. I mean, bringing Reason's money down like that is super important going into this round. I mean, they still have a lot of money, but instead of maybe buying 3 rounds in a row, they can only buy 2 rounds in a row. So I think that was really, really important by Peter and well played. Picking up an AK, saving themselves another 3K of money. Also very, very good. And this is their shot. They need to string rounds together and get to 8. Otherwise, it's going to be trouble.
Okay, he's looking for that pick on Carr. He might find something, actually, as they do go towards Carr. Good. That's very good nade work there, completely denying Cadian. Very, very well played by SK Gaming to take over Banana. And they're going to realize very soon exactly what's going on. Reason piling into mid once again. But Huitin and Rook coming out huge with a great defense. Four players going down straight away. Cadian, the last man standing on the flank there with the AWP. He's going to have to try to keep this alive somehow. But that was a... that was just a great, some great counter flashes, some great crossfire coming in from SK Gaming. And really, they need to stop this round count from getting out of control from Reason. And it looks like a very timely, timely stop. But Cadian does still have something to say.
Yep, he wants to bring SK's money down and save his off, possibly. But it's still a lot of time left and they know where he is. So he's probably not going to make it happen, but... two more kills, and that could be really important for a reason.
I like how he's getting out of that really awkward position, but here it is, a close range, no scope, can he get it? No! Huitin gets the kill, and Cadian only picked off one in the end there, so not a lot of value from the AWP, unfortunately, and that's always very heartbreaking when you saved up, oh, I can finally buy my AWP, and you get one kill, and then you lose the round.
Well, that was really important for SK to actually get some momentum back. And hopefully win two rounds in a row, but are they forced by or only one AK?
Evening up the money. Up,
yeah, but really important for SK, and probably gonna get two rounds in a row, which is...
ooh.
That's what exactly what they needed.
Wow.
Good play there. They just take them both straight down. And I think that smoke, that deep smoke from SK was a big, big tell that they were about to be aggressive. Really, really good reaction, good response from Reason. Now they have taken over the bomb site. They did pick up the two weapons. This could get really grim now for SK. They absolutely need this round. Here they swing on through for this retake. MSL by Paul there, great position. So it's going to be really tough to contend with Huitin, though. He's the first man in. He's going to catch him. Oh, he does catch one player. MSL does get the trade, though. Great crossfires coming in. Rock going to take down the last man in the back of the... oh, no, there's Nilla still left, but he will fall. And that was a great eco from Reason. MSK.
Yeah, but still an amazing retake, because that shouldn't have gone the way it went, I think. Because they had four men. They had, like, the perfect positions to actually block their retake, but... obviously, not having armor on most people probably screwed them over, but it was a really good eco, but a really well-played retake by SK Gaming.
The timings and the crossfires on the retake were really sick, I've got to say. Oh, XM, he's going to pull out the AWP here. There is the first gun to MSL, and they know what's up at this point, and that's a big deal. Before, I think you pointed out that sometimes Reason didn't look so confident on their plan B. Right now, it's got to be a plan B. Looks like they're just going for the rush straight up. The pace is unreal. They're moving with blinding speed into the A bomb site. SK had no idea what hit them. PNX with another great shot onto XM again. And it is a 3-on-3. I cannot believe how fast they moved in. I don't think SK can even comprehend it at this point. They're just trying to go for the retake. But Reason, they got some good positions for this.
Yeah, that's the negative part about playing 2-on-1 and only one short slash apartments. You can actually make those fast pushes work, and retake is now working out for SK, as they're a bit undecisive when to push in.
And at least they're all going to die. They should all die. There it is. Bomb does explode. But actually, that said, this is the last round of the first half, so... This is turning out to be a really awesome match between SK Gaming and Reason. Both teams displaying some remarkable strength on their respective sides at this point. And I wonder if SK Gaming will take it a bit more easy on Banana, because they do love that. They're so aggressive every round. It's great.
I do want SK to actually change their setup on A, which they seem to be doing now. They seem to have a more apartment-based setup. Which I think is fine. I don't really like the... oh, the push is coming in. They're already taking A. If Shitting cannot stop it, and he can. Nilla takes him down, and they already have A. And a 3-on-3 after plant situation is about to begin.
All on Rock here as they move in. First man. All going to move through quad. So it's going to be really, really tough here. As Rock makes his way in with his teammate. They don't have any nades. Oh, they do have one flash and one HE, but it's not going to help them at this point. There, though, flash is going to the back of the site. Cadian, though, just blind as hell moving around. Rock can't quite seem to kill him. Finally, he's going to fall, but the bomb is so far ticked. Rock has no health left on him. This has got to be the round for Reason. That's a 9-6 first half for Reason Gaming. What a fantastic first half for them. All right, so a small pause. All right, so tell me some of the things that you liked the most from this half we saw.
The decisive pushes from Reason Gaming when they actually had Banana. They worked out that they were kind of weak on the apartment slash short side, so they just made a quick decision and just pushed short in apartments, and they got the site every time they did it, and got into the after plans, and they played them well enough to get 9 rounds on the board. And I think the quick decision making on Reason was a big factor.
Yeah, that's a really, really good point, actually. That last round, it was just, I was about to be like, you know, throwing in the criticisms, like, oh, they don't know what to do, you know. But then they really did know what to do, because they're like, we're hitting A, boom. They just straight, they just went for it just so fast. I love it. Like, they didn't care about nades or anything, just went in, completely caught them off guard. What do you think about the banana play from SK Gaming? Because they had a lot of aggression there. I think that's more aggression than I usually see. Usually when I watch Dignitas, for example, they play a lot of aggression, but not quite that much on banana.
I think it's more about controlling the actual push. I mean, if you're going aggressive on banana, you kind of need to block off A, because it's very likely that a fast A push is coming, because it's really hard to retake banana once CT control it with molotovs and nades and smokes. You cannot really push the smoke down banana, because it's really, really risky. You'll lose like 9 out of 10 rounds on retaking banana. So, I think they just needed a better plan on how to actually block the push towards A.
All right. Well, it seemed like they did a good job, though. They did make it work for the most part. I mean, we had some funny moments, like Emilio just getting roasted behind the car. That was pretty nice. But generally speaking, what are your expectations now going into? Well, of course, we're having the switch of sides here. What do you think is going to happen here? Is SK Gaming going to be better on the attacking side, or?
I think they like attacking more. I just think it's going to be an even game. I do believe that SK probably will take 70 rounds at the least. So.
All right. Okay. So you think it's going to be a close one?
Yeah.
All right. So there you go. So have you been to London before? Have you been to England before?
Yes, I have once before. I was in the Fnatic headquarters with Patrick Karn, and I've been to the Meltdown bar and played a couple of games.
Oh, of course, I remember that. I casted that. Yeah. I think, or at least I was present when it was being casted. Yeah, yeah.
So I mean, I like London, and all the people is really nice, it's great. Talking English and understanding people, I
definitely
guess.
that's a big plus for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, having been in Italy for a while, it's pretty hard when people don't speak English. But so we were talking in the break as well a little bit about actually it seems like they're getting ready. I just hear in my ear, so I might have to save this topic for later. I was gonna ask you a bit about your team at the moment, how things are going, and but seems like we are jumping to the match again. So we're about to see what will be the story here between SK and Reason. Definitely, you could say these two guys are perhaps, maybe, would you say these are two favorites here for this qualifier?
I don't really know. I mean, there's so many even teams. I mean, even though, like, the score lines has been pretty big, but I don't know. SK should be one of the favorites. Reason is kind of like a wild card.
Right.
They seem to have gelled well, as you mentioned. That's really important for them. Cadian is going for a really aggressive peak.
Going for some booms, but won't find anything just yet. And It's nice though. It gets quick some quick information. I do like that little push from Cadian. They can't really be too exploited, I guess, unless they decide to pre-nade it, which is a bit of a crazy investment on the pistol round. So I like that from Cadian. It's pretty cool. But it seems as if the response there from SK, they're slowing things down. They're just holding their positions here, and they're going to make reason guess. You know what is going to come here, and
I think they want to blow enough time to make reason doubt they're actually going in a push. Because if he saw four guys on in street second mid, it's probably gonna go be an A push. So they're just gonna let time go, let time slide for a bit, and then make them have two at B instead of four at A. And the push is coming now towards A.
This is actually working out really well. Even Reason blowing some nades for nothing, and now finally they come in, and it's almost too easy. XM dropping from the air to take the headshot onto PNX. Nilla's there to return a frag, but the bomb is planted. 2-on-3. I don't see a kit. That is a big problem right now. Good nade there from Nilla. Just crushing XM in the pit. He's trying to make his way back on. He's got to get something else here. All alone. And they're going to take him out. So there you go. SK going to take the pistol round, and that's going to really work to tie the whole score.
It's going to work in my predictions favor. Mm-hmm. At least 7 rounds. This is a good start.
So here we go. We're going to see an anti-eco from Reason. Are they going to get cute? Looks like that is exactly what's going to happen. Are they going to stack it or are they going to rush it? Looks like they're going to rush it. Maybe?
I think they're just going to wait until they hear the steps, throw a flash from the site, and just push out altogether.
This would be amazing. They do have a couple flashes. They're going, here go the flashes, the pop flashes, and they're so good. They're going to get one frag from it. Emilio, though, going hero mode. He only gets two, three. Can he get any more? He gets three frags. Unbelievable. I can't believe it. And Nilem MSR is still left. They're going to pick up the weapons. But that, I love that. That the flashing over was great. And looks like SK got to be careful here. Although Nilla's not going to do much with a Nova from this range.
But it's a perfect, perfect flash at the exact right time.
Yes.
And I'm really surprised Emilio got three kills there. It seems like he should have been dead after one. Mm. Missing a lot of bullets with the Galil, but the Glocks proved to be better for him there. But yeah, could have gone really badly for SK if Emilio didn't pick up those frags. They could have gotten three extra guns, and steamrolled them as the bomb was actually down towards slope. So could have blocked that off as well. So important by Emilio.
And that was definitely worth the investment. Couple flashes. And what are the value of those flashes right there? Wow.
Yeah, it was was it a full eco or did they buy?
I think they had they didn't have any armor, I don't think. It was just a couple flashes and I think some pistols. So
really
nice.
Really well spent money.
And look at this, Nilla, with the Nova Soul. Is he going to get sandbags or something? Nope. Going to just maybe get boosted, perhaps. Anything interesting? I want to see a nice little spot for this Nova.
Is he alone B and free pushing apartments?
Ooh, looks like it.
They spot him. Double boost mid. They're boosted up.
For this position. This is a really sweet position. Oh, look at that boost. Working out very well. Falling back. They didn't lose anything for that. That's great. They won't pick up the weapon, though. Or at least SK, it'd be kind of...
This is the shot Reason has, is when SK lose the entry, they make maybe a too quick of a decision, and they get the rotation in to stop it. It seems like that's happening.
Nova time. Can he get anything with this? He's in a great position. This is very close range. It's exactly what he wants. And he hears the bomb plant today. Oh, he knows the angle just gets slightly wrong, and he's not going to get a single thing with that Nova. Very sad there. Emilio put under a lot of pressure. XM and Rock here on the back of the site. Oh, he's trying to go for a knife there. I don't know, but what a round. That was sickeningly good. Disgusting round from Reason. What an eco. Amazing.
Yeah, kind of what I said, they kind of made a decision too quickly, and they went for the plant in the smoke, which was risky as well. Nearly almost got him with the Nova, and
this boost, what was it, was here?
Yeah, in middle. That was right really, really good.
That was so sweet.
It's the old 1.6 boost. not very used commonly today, but works out fine.
A little bit of aggression here, and Miller gonna get some support from himself. Oh, Miller's in trouble. The shotgun's so scary. Does live to tell the tale, though. And that smoke is going to stop them from pushing any further. So they did a good job there.
Strafe dodges all the shotgun bullets.
Look at XM, one health on him. He loves his Nova. He really does. Nova's pretty good. I think the Nova's very valuable shotgun. It's only 1,200, but it's sickeningly good close range. Nice spam from Emilio. Going to pick off MSL over at Banana. That's gonna be really confusing for Reason right now, because SK Gaming are actually pushing mid a little bit, as we can see there. Smoking everything off. They pushed the line of Reason's defense all the way back. So Reason really don't understand what's happening right now. And they are gonna have to try to push Banana to try to figure out what's going on.
And Reason doesn't really have any anti-nades left. So SK, if they make a push, they just need to be ready. Well, SK doesn't really have nades either. So this is gonna just be a... Someone is spawn. Peter is in spawn, flanking them.
Two in spawn. What a very, very nasty B split that they're playing. Cadian, no health with that AWP. This is gonna be really important for him to get some frags. There's the first kill from Cadian. Are we looking for a boom? We don't find it. Cadian gonna go down, and Reason are looking very, very troubled at the moment. It's just PNX at the moment. He does manage to get himself a frag. And XM's on very low health in the corner there. And he's going to flick around. He doesn't get it onto XM. And
5 HP in total. Gets the round, SK. Really important round. Because they're almost every player is broke, it seems like, on the whole game. They're ecoing on Reason's side and full buying with zero cash left almost on the SK side. But I do like the decision Reason is taking to grab an eco, even though they could have forced bot, but they rather play it safe. They have the rounds, no need to stress, play it safe.
They're going to flash over, going to think, yeah, there it is. Oh, and it's going to work way better this time. Oh, that's so... I think so many people are going to be copying that, because it's so easy to do that setup. Oh, God, it's so good. And Reason Gaming looking, they're flying at the start of this eco round. They got themselves some guns. So they are already looking good now. And this is very bad, because we can see the money is terrible for SK. Really, really terrible. And this is the round that can really get Reason ahead. And out of an eco, that's fantastic to see.
Yeah, and this is so dangerous for SK. They cannot really cover anything. So they feel like they want to make a push before they get cornered in. Without the CTs knowing where they're going. So might be trouble for SK.
There you go, they make their way in. Good work there from Cadian and right at the balcony. There moves in with the CZ. Doesn't quite make it happen. Let's have a look and see if MSL and PNX can do this. Running in all the way from B, rotating now. AK in the hands of MSL. He has head armor and Kevlar to work with too, so good spot. Oh, he's getting caught from two sides at once. This is very tough to deal with. MSL looking at all the angles. It's being played right now for a full, but he's going to catch the head of Pitt. It's a one-on-one, and XM is insanely low. MSL is so close to doing this. Oh, XM with a headshot onto MSL. Amazing stuff there from XM.
That was pretty amazing how they turned out there. 3-on-5. And they actually got a trade in on the A side, so it was like a 2-on-4 for a while, and they actually won that round, which is pretty amazing, seeing how Reason got early guns from Banana. So yeah, good play from Michael, and I'm not sure who the last one is, Emilio. As Emilio gets two entries on Banana and has clear entrance to the B side. He doesn't know it yet, but two men are rotating towards B from the CT side.
Danes love the aggression on Banana as well, seems as much as the Swedes do. And let's see if Cadian's going to be able to save it with his AWP. It always feels like Cadian's in very hard positions with his AWP, like he's never able to really just be comfortable with it. Like, for example, whenever he has the AWP, you know, A doesn't really get challenged very much, or it seems as if B gets taken over, so he has to run over there and you know, has to be mobile with his AWP. It's very awkward for him, unfortunately, every time he invests there. But the bomb is planted. We've got a 3-on-2 situation. Again, Kaden having to move in slowly with his AWP. Awkward angles, but he's good enough to pull it off. Gets the first kill onto Rock. PNX making his way through from CT spawn. There goes the nade, and he finds one close range. Takes down Pitta. Might just find the next one. Kaden can do this with the USP. He does it, and that is the round there for Reason. What a wonderful retake there. Really good work.
Wow. I didn't think they would actually make it. They had so little time. PNX came in on a very, very late rotation. The T side had good setups, but took the duels too early and too one-on-one-y, I guess.
Yeah, no, that's totally right. And against Kaden's AWP, it didn't work out so well. And another awkward fight at pool, things going well. And maybe now Kaden's going to get a chance to use that AWP. And he does get smoked out of mid, it seems. See a lot of action.
Seems like they're setting up with the same flash, but Nidla didn't spot anyone. So just smoking out.
I like the smoke a lot as well. It's the kind of in-between one. It's not as deep as logs, but it's like we kind of want to take control of it on a little bit. Yeah. But it's like SK going to make their way in onto the A bomb site. Jumping down to Pit, not going to happen. PNX to stop him. Kaden also with the stop onto XM. Pit to the fall as well. SK Gaming falling to pieces with only Emilio able to take a stand. Bomb does go down though, but it's going to be really tough. Emilio falls as well. Good cleanup. Reason Gaming. Beautiful defense on the A.
Important that they actually got the plans. They might be able to buy now. They've lost a couple of rounds in a row. No, they're actually very broke. Wow. Well, SK Gaming not looking very, very good right now. They haven't won any weapon rounds, I believe. I think they've only won against the Ecos, and they had quite a bit of trouble against the Ecos as well.
We're seeing push from on Banana rather, as again from SK Gaming. Or it's not necessarily a push, but they are waiting for the smoke to go away so they can maybe make a move. Does seem very committed though, and they are of course on an eco. They have a couple smokes so that they really they're planning to get into the bomb site basically. I don't know if they're gonna get a chance to use those smokes, but we're soon going to find out.
Yep. And Reason seem to be playing a double long. They have fast rotations towards B, so I mean, I wouldn't see SK Gaming being able to actually pull this off.
It's gonna be tough.
They do not have any smokes on B left, if not the guys on long is actually smoking for them, but doesn't seem to be the case.
And they did fall back from those close positions, which may have been better for this, the defense here. MSL, but I love that smoke on Coils. Really smart, very strong, but MSL still gets a kill anyway. Nilla as well with a bunch of kills. MSL still on the site, just popping off the heads of the incoming Swedes. And it's going to be very problematic for XM to do anything here. He has got himself an M4, but Kaden going to take him out. 13-10, Reason really carving a good lead into the game now. You can see the money situation is getting quite nice for them, and we do get the buy coming in for SK Gaming, so it really feels like everything's on this round.
Yeah, and my guess is they're going for a B play after a while, but wow. They're trying to shut this weapon round down, and they succeed with getting free entries, trading for one, and yeah, they're keeping up with the trading, and
so sick.
This is one of the most frustrating things you can face, is when you're probably having a discussion on the eco, trying to figure out what to do against their style, and they just rush you, and you don't even have the chance to execute your plan.
Condition to kind of leave mid because Kaden's always there, so maybe they smoke it from near spawn or something, but they don't want to show themselves there.
Yeah.
And so, you know, they wait. Reason wait. They wait. They know it maybe at the start of the game. We're going to use this once, but they wait for their moment and they make it count. And what a moment to choose to throw that surprise that, you know, that's a surprise. It's in the bag of tricks for Reason Gaming into the mix, and it's gonna.
The win, and they have to make something work quick because they're gonna be outnated so badly. They basically threw away 1/6 of their nades there with just an HP.
The classic smoke we're seeing quite often here from SK, and yeah, I'm really, really amazed by Reason's performance. It does seem like they have gelled a little bit together. They have some good teamwork going in there and definitely working well with one another. So, Khalil's spammed everywhere on Banana, taking it slow. They do have a good opportunity on mid, actually, because of how far back Reason are playing, but that's not information
Reason
they have.
Reason is setting up for the flash play again.
Might see if this works.
Mike take Emilio off guard.
Wow.
Oh, it wasn't Emilio, it was Michaelele with the backup.
Good
and
stuff.
Seems like they're pushing towards B. Getting the entry there. Kind of waiting out Reason to get impatient.
Kaden getting caught there. Very good round so far from SK, taking control of that B bomb site. Kaden, 5 health though. And I think they have good enough money that he can just go for this and just like make the money situation even worse by getting some frags here. If not, try to take it. Oh,
wow.
My God, Exa going massive here on the other side of things. Kaden's going to go all the way around. That's a grill going to put the defuse. And oh, it's all down to Kaden. This one-on-one is almost impossible for him. What does he do? Does he hold it? Does he fake it? He's got no time. And Whitten playing it perfectly. Is there time?
Nope.
Is there time? No, he doesn't get it. Just one more second. That's all he needed. Very well played from Whitten there. Exa, my goodness. Didn't expect that coming in from him there. And
he's actually performing really well. He has 21 frags. KDM with 23, top fragging for his team. And on the other side, we have Exa, Michaelele, top fragging on his team. So we got the top performers there. And KD and EXR almost made that retake. Was it 2-on-4 possible? So really well played.
KD was a missed flick shot there and falling back. And I wonder if SK can make any efforts on mid here. Feels like we haven't challenged mid that much,
no,
to be honest. And they're giving up Banana, so we are seeing what looks like a setup here for mid. They might go for that. The pit smoke and the smoke on Arch and make their way through the quad, but actually quad gets smoked here. So that's going to really hurt them if they want to push through quad. And PNX in pit, really good position. Getting a lot of trades going on in as they push through mid. PNX going to shut down the apartments push right there as MSL isn't going to rotate just yet, but they must have seen the bomb surely.
Yeah.
See it there. Emilio, stuff from him. Oh, but the bomb is dropped. Medio last man standing in a 1-on-2. Crucial, crucial round here for SK Gaming.
This is a really awkward position for Emilio. The rotation is coming short, holding. He kind of needs to go. I think he's going to fake plant, yeah. He kind of needs to get that kill, but he's not going to get it.
Just waiting patiently. He's got 20 seconds now. And there is the plant. It goes down. Emilio's got to worry about an angle in front of him and behind him at the same time. They're going to synchronize well. Cannot get the first kill. MSL shuts him down. That's going to be another round for Reason as they go 15-11 on the scoreboard. And the money, it's not good.
Wow.
It's not good.
It's not good at all. The best they can do is drop an AK.
That is the best they can do. Do you feel like we didn't see enough mid and apartments? Because that's how I feel. I feel like I would have wanted to see more experimentation.
More short
there.
And apartments pushes from SK. Getting those after plant situations. Because Reason seem to be pretty contested. Oh, they're going for the push again. They want to end it now.
And then they're wondering, where the hell are they? And look how far back SK are playing, actually.
I think they actually were so far behind because they were dropping in spawn.
Yeah.
So they actually didn't have the time to push up. That's pretty interesting, pretty funny.
But they did do what you said. They did grab the. They did go for the drops.
Yeah.
So that's really nice. It actually doesn't look like a too much of a terrible buy from them. They can work with this. It's something you can work with. And this is an interesting round now, considering how much reason pushed. And we can see them. They fell back immediately to what looks like a very standard setup.
Yeah. And MSL has taken a lot of damage. So if they would go for a B, even though there's two players there, I mean, he can go down really quickly. And seems like they're going for that short push, but now Reason is actually countering them with two on pit.
Good nades coming in from Reason. Some counter flashes going in. Great angle for Exa. Going to take down a couple players. All those bullets from the M4, and that's it for him. Lights out. But XM, he's got no gas left. And that is going to be at 16 to 11.
In game. This is good in game.
Okay, it's going nuts.